What I'd like to show you today is the story of using a crop wild relative in plant breeding research. In this case, we have Teosinte, the wild ancestor of corn. And this is an accession that was collected in southern Mexico near the presumed location of domestication. Notice how bushy it is. Notice the extreme amount of tillering, the number of stems at the base of the plant. And also notice there's no tassels or ears. It hasn't started to go into reproductive phase yet, because the photoperiod here at 40 degrees north is completely wrong. It may start flowering within a couple of weeks. This was crossed onto domesticated corn with the idea of finding useful traits for kernel composition, things like oil and protein percentage, for yield components like kernel weight and number of kernels per row, and for disease resistance. So a number of objectives in mind. This row here shows the F1 between Teosinte and corn, F1 being the direct result of a cross between those two parents. Still a large amount of tillering. There is a hint of going toward a prominent main stalk here, but still many, many tillers, and has not started to tassel yet at this stage. At the F1, we have 50% Teosinte DNA. Moving along, this is called the BC1 generation, the first backcross. So this would be the result of crossing the corn parent to the F1. In principle, 25% Teosinte DNA. So you can really see the much reduced tillering at this stage, the prominent major stalk, and it is tasseling right now. So the reproductive behavior is becoming more similar to corn adapted to the temperate U.S. Then we have the BC4. This is the result of 4 backcrosses to the corn parent. So in principle, 4% Teosinte DNA, the rest being corn. So notice we basically have a corn plant here, a single dominant stalk, very reduced amount of tillering. The tasseling and flowering is already complete. So very much like the corn parent, which is shown here in the adjacent row. To do this completely, we would need to do at least a couple of hundred different BC4 lines, because every time you produce the BC4, a different segment of Teosinte DNA would be incorporated. So to look at the value across the whole genome, we would want a broad array of lines like this one here. Hopefully we'll find something useful in this material. I should say that this material was provided by Sherry Flint Garcia, a USDA employee in Columbia, Missouri.